divine chaplain, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Father, Lord, in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Holy God, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, was conceived of the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead, and on the third day rose from the dead. Ascended into heaven and seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the living and the dead.
By the Holy Spirit of our Lord and Church, we are in the saints, forgive us our sins, resurrection of our body, and life everlasting. Amen.
Eternal Father, I ask for your body and blood, soul and divinity, and your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ.
And the atonement of our sins and those of the whole world.
Sake of the sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and the whole world.
For the sake of the sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and the whole world.
For the sake of the sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and the whole world.
For the sake of the sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and the whole world.
For the sake of the sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and the whole world.
For the sake of the sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and the whole world.
Eternal Father, I offer you the body and blood, soul and divinity of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ.
And in our sins and those of the world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and the whole world.
Eternal Father, I offer you the body and blood, soul and divinity of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ.
In the atonement of our sins and those of the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have mercy on us and the whole world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion,
have
Have mercy on us and all the world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and all the world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and all the world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and all the world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and all the world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and all the world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and all the world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and all the world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and all the world.
For the sake of his sorrowful passion.
Have mercy on us and all the world.
Holy God.
Holy God. Holy Lord. Have mercy on us and all the world. Holy God. Holy Mighty One. Holy Lord. Have mercy on us. Jesus, I ask you.
Good morning.
Good morning, Father.
Sorry I'm late this morning. My knee and I didn't have a very good night. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
With your spirit.
Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mystery. You are sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest.
And on earth, peace to thee, O Lord. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us.
You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ. With the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God and the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who will that your only begotten Son should undergo the cross to save the human race, grant, we pray, that we who have known his mystery on earth may merit the grace of his redemption in heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Numbers. With their patience worn out by the journey, the people complained against God and Moses. Why have you brought us up from the land of Egypt to die in this desert, where there is no food or water? We are disgusted with this wretched food. In punishment, the Lord sent among the people seraph serpents, which bit the people so that many of them died. Then the people came to Moses and said, "We have sinned in complaining against the Lord and you. Pray the Lord to take the serpents from us." So Moses prayed for the people, and the Lord said to Moses, "Make a seraph and mount it on a pole, and if any who have been bitten look at it, they will be healed, they will live." Moses accordingly made a bronze serpent and mounted it on a pole, and whenever anyone who had been bitten by a serpent looked at the bronze serpent, he lived. The word of the Lord.
Thanks.
Do not forget the works of the Lord.
Do not forget the works of the Lord.
Hearken, my people, to my teaching. Incline your ears to the words of my mouth. I will open my mouth in a parable. I will utter mysteries from of old.
Do not forget the works of the Lord.
While he slew them, they sought him and inquired after God again, remembering that God was their rock and the Most High God their Redeemer. But they flattered him with their mouths and lied to him with their tongues, though their hearts were not steadfast toward him nor were they faithful to his covenant. But he, being merciful, forgave their sin and destroyed them not. Often he turned back his anger and let none of his wrath be roused. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, Christ Jesus, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God something to be grasped. Rather, he emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, coming in human likeness. And found human in appearance, he humbled himself, becoming obedient to death, even death on a cross. Because of this, God greatly exalted him and bestowed on him the name that is above every name, that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bend, of those in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Because by your cross, you have redeemed the world.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to Nicodemus, "No one has gone up to heaven except the one who has come down from heaven, the Son of Man. And just as Moses lifted up the serpent in the desert, so must the Son of Man be lifted up, so that everyone who believes in him may have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but might have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world might be saved through him." The Gospel.
Praise
the Son of Man must be lifted up. There's a retreat house at Barrington, Illinois. The grounds surrounding it are filled with beautiful trees. Somewhere among the trees is a stone cross, crucifix actually. It is especially striking at night because the way it's been lighted. On rainy nights, it's even more striking because water trickles down the face and body of Jesus. One night, a retreatant came upon the cross. The light shining on the stone and the water trickling down the body of Jesus moved the retreatant deeply. He walked up to the cross and he touched the cross, not the body of Jesus. He touched the cross. And touched it again reverently. And later he said, "I wasn't worthy enough to touch the body of Jesus." How reverently do we regard the cross of Jesus? Lord, by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. You are the Savior of the world.
great hope, Lord. And for an effective vaccine against the COVID virus amid all this nonsense we have to go through every day, we pray to the Lord.
This Mass is offered for the repose of the soul of Robert Kowalski. For this intention, let us continue to pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for our Holy Father, Pope Francis, and all who shepherd our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for leaders of nations, may they be blessed by the Holy Spirit with a heart open to the truth of God's word. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for the grace to see every human being, regardless of race, language, or culture, as a child of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to abortion and for the legal protection of unborn children everywhere, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our military troops engaged in dangerous missions, that they be protected by God watching over them and returned safely to their families, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this community of faith, may the Lord bless our relationships and grant us purity of heart and mind. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, including Walter Hodge Wapany, for whom Our Lady of Grace Candle burns this week, may they be held this day by the crucified and risen Son of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for those petitions we hold within the silence of our hearts. For these, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty Father, we ask you to hear the prayers which we bring before you humbly, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. For through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth, the work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. For through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual bread.
Blessed be God.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, your Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hand, the praise of your Lord, our good Lord, and our soul.
May this oblation, O Lord, which on the altar of the cross canceled the offense of the whole world, cleanse us, we pray, from all of our sins, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks,
so that where death arose, life might again spring forth. And the evil one who conquered on a tree might likewise on a tree be conquered through Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exaltation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs and humble praise as we acclaim. Holy,
holy, holy,
holy Lord God of hosts,
heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fountain of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the new thing, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord, Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord,
and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with our Pope, with us, with our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
"Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil."
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the
coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom of God, the glory of God, is now and
forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant justice.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word, my soul is blessed.
Thank you.
Let us pray.
Having been nourished by your holy banquet, we beseech you, Lord Jesus Christ, to bring those you have redeemed by the word of your life-giving cross to the glory of the resurrection, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Jesus, Lord of Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth. The Mass is
okay. Yeah. Okay. And at the end, when it's all over, I'll walk.